Okay, we're not still piking because we are still chilling here in Morzel, that we still have enough food. People are only panicking because about their wealth. They got everything. They got all money what they had, but here in Morzel we have all food. So what's going on in this plant? People are just only have their own money, which is that until now are panicking. And we were here, still standing, we're still smiling, and food are still here. Food are here. So if you are, people are preparing to have some meal, it's a halal product. Halal products are still available in the neighborhood. This is Bernie the Jazzman. I would like to have my kip, special kip, that halal kip. If you can't buy no more kip, there are still product here. Hope you're gonna see it later when I show it, how I'm gonna cook my chicken to share it to you guys, that there were still chicken available in this planet. So we talk about the people are believing with food, lots of money, but people here, the halal product are still here in the neighborhood of Morzel, are still available. So what we have, just happy cooking with the Jazzman. Take care, love you all a lot. Okay, my friend, once again, this is the Jazzman. In my city, we're still not a ghost town. We are still here with lots of potatoes, fresh fruits, and also a friend of mine, also the specialized on Moroccan product, and that's the big boss. All right, it's a halal product that I'm gonna share it again with you guys. That see, you don't have to be panicked. That we had everything that we had, a product, a fresh product. Look at what we had. So I don't understand why people are panicking for their food. And we still have all this product, halal product, and we are here still in the neighborhood. So come along here in Morzel. We are all here. So you don't have to be panicked, because for how many more days that we have to share this product, and we're not gonna get loose. We are still here. We're still safe. You have to be a believer, because when they believe, you believe in God, and God never forsake you. What kind of religion you are, there's always, when you believe, there's always food for everybody. This is Bernie the Jazzman reporting for you guys. Love you all a lot. Mabuhay.
Alright. Okay. Good afternoon once again. This is Bernie the Jazzman. Today I would like to show some special experience for me here in Europe, that I would like to attempt to make some soup, so you can also see it how I make my soup with wonton made of chicken breast, with all these ingredients that I'm gonna put: onions, paprika, parsley, chili, and also a little bit of garlic. And I'm gonna put also some mushroom on it, and then I'm gonna put some gluten rice. So I'm gonna make that one as to make my wonton. I don't use egg, but I use that rice. And for the soup, I'm gonna use some soya, chicken stock, and I have this celery. I got the parsnip, of course, potatoes, onions to thicken it up, so I can make my soup thicken. So you can always use flour with butter, roux, but I prefer always potatoes, it's more healthy. Alright, I hope you enjoy it. So the rest of the chicken legs and the rest, I'm gonna put it on my stock to make my soup, and the chicken breast, which is, I'm gonna grind it over here to put all the ingredients. I'm gonna put all this together, the chicken breast inside and my gluten rice. I hope you see it. I'm gonna mass it later. So let's start cooking. All right.
I hope you can see how I start my soup. This is a real typical Pinoy and a bit European touch. I've learned it a long time here in Belgium. It's a quite very healthy soup to start it. Okay, I hope you enjoy it. Let's start cooking. All right, this is Bernie the Jazz Man. Mabuhay po kayo. Let's start cooking. All right.
All right, that's my onions. So I think for one whole chicken, for 1 day, 2 day soup, I think three onions would be enough. Then the parsnip, just start peel them already. See, actually parsnip and celeriac, the celery, they have the same perfume. Actually, they have, they're about families, eh? They're all roots, eh? Carrots, parsnip, beetroot, they're all actually root, eh? All right, and the aroma, it's really amazing, eh? Parsnip and lots of vitamin also. All right, once again, the Jazz Man, music by Spyro Gyra. So we're just not only cooking. So I just want you to know that this some kind of music. It's jazz and happy cooking with the Jazz Man. Let's make how they call soup number 5, secret of my success. So some people like pinapaita. Well, you have different aroma with pinapaitan, but this one also you have the same energy. All this boost meal, eh? Special soup. All right, put it over there. Put this one in the lababa for a while. Then I clean up afterwards. Okay, then we don't need that one. So we need the celery act. So you cut it like this. Bend it over. Right. See, the aroma is just a family of parsnip. Right. Then we're gonna cut it into a chunk pieces. The smaller is your celery, the better for your soup to cook quick. Eh? I'm gonna pan fry this one in a casserole together with a little bit of onions, the parsnip, and of course I always cook it with the soy butter. Then I'm gonna use also some soy milk. Yeah, lots of people don't really like to try to minimize dairy products, so it doesn't matter. So we just have to behave. Then we're gonna cut this one in a small chunk there. Then we just fry it with butter and of course potatoes also. Alright, and then I'm gonna cut it in a small chunk and we're gonna cook it slowly with soya butter. Then I'm gonna put my chicken stock. Then I'm gonna boil the rest of my chicken. Eh? Alright, I hope you're gonna see all this structure. I'm gonna do it. Alright. Alright, that's the pasta next. Right. potatoes. All right, then it's about time to wet them in butter. Just lightly color the onions. So you have the smoky taste on your butter and your soup. While you put your stock on it, your chicken broth. Well, it's smelly, buttery, creamy, with soya. All right. We're gonna use that chicken for your garniture and for the chicken broth also. All right. That's about it. Then the carcass, we're gonna use it also. But actually, the fat, I don't really like the fat. Eh? I mean, yeah, okay. Especially this one, I don't really need it. Huh? So just open it like this. Just watch out to make sure that your knife is sharp. Just go to the border of the bone, the structure, and then it's easy. And then you just put it like this. Put your finger over there, and you have it. And the same also on the other side. All right. Just okay. This one, I can do nothing about this, but well, what I'm gonna do is gonna boil it. Part of the stock, eh? Just and try to wash it a little bit because there's always in there also blood on it and then the fat away. Also, okay, just try to minimize the bad part because okay, you have to take also the skin, you know, and the fat. Okay, you only need that. Okay, some people like that fat, not me. I don't really like that one. Well, some that this one is really important, but and the fat for the taste also. But you don't need that one when you wanna make a healthy food. You don't need that stuff. It's like jazz. Huh? The quality what you do is the same music what you play. All right. So this one, what I'm gonna do with this one? I'm gonna try to cut in two small pieces immediately and make sure also sometimes there's still bone, be left behind. You don't need that, but take it away, cut it in small chunks. Also the legs you can also use it, but I prefer that one to use it for the chicken broth, because chicken legs have more of a taste. This is a native chicken. This is what they call a chicken halal. Run away from the garden and it was been less while they slaughtered the chicken. It's very religious chicken what I have here. It's a lovely chicken anyhow. You can see the quality of the chicken. Well, all chicken all the same, but I don't know. Alright, you see this one? So for the rest, this one, I just that one also I'm going to use it for chicken broth. What I'm going to do, so I'm going to put this one, some few more mushroom. I got the mushroom also, forgot to cut my mushroom also, but anyhow. Alright, small pieces like your chicken. Then that's the stuffing for the wonton, sort of ravioli what I'm gonna do with it. So So some people use eggs, but I don't use egg. And I use gluten rice, huh? Or flour, something like this. So I just, this one, just gonna mash it like this until it's gonna get a flour. Okay? I'm gonna put it over here for a while. So I'm gonna start putting it. Everything that's for my stuffing. I'm gonna put my chicken inside. Small pieces. A little bit of mushroom. A little paprika. A bit of onion. Garlic on it. Anyhow, you can mix it again afterwards. It doesn't matter. So we just only turn it, grind it. Okay. So only try to grind it like this. Okay. Then it goes inside. Okay. And we have the meat inside. So we grind. Okay. That's it. All right. Right, that's about it. Yeah? So just only you need some machine, mince to mince your chicken, mushroom, paprika are all here, and of course the ingredients. So you can make your dim sum or wonton. It's easy. But what you're gonna do now? I just made this a while ago. So it's just the rice, you know, gluten rice. They call it lakatan. So it was really right. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add it a little bit. Some, a lot, not really so much. Maybe two small, a little bit, one more. Then just mix it. Huh? Just mix it. So make sure your salt and pepper, it's enough, because otherwise you're gonna soak it into a bouillon, eh? You're gonna poach them. Eh? Ravioli or wonton dim sum, it's about the same procedure. Eh? So mince it well. So once you poach it in the water, what happened? They stick together. So that's why I use lakatan. It's a gluten rice. Eh? All right. You can really smell the soya. Mushroom, paprikas, parsley, and coriander. So I'm gonna make the ravioli in a few minutes. But in the meantime, I try to make the soup already. Then I show you how to do it, all right? All right, that's the soya butter on it. Onion and parsnip, it doesn't matter. Just let them a little bit sweat it a little bit. Alright, just potatoes, you can put it afterwards when the parsnip and onion will be not sweating. Alright, sweat it for a while. Gonna put the celery. Right.
Let it sweat for a while. Let it dissolve for a while. And you can smell it already. We're gonna put some chicken broth on it. Let's wait for a while, alright? And in the meantime, we're gonna show you how to make the wonton, alright? Then we're gonna put the chicken stock. The soup is almost ready, and that's also the extra bouillon I'm gonna use it, and I put it also together. Then I'm gonna add the soya cream on it. Alright. Alright, now the soup, it's okay. The parsnip, pastinak. Celery wrap, it's almost finished. Then I'm gonna add the soya milk already. Alright. See? Then you just wanna have to turn off your fire. Or maybe you can still do it with a very, very low fire. Alright. That will be enough for the moment. Then you see consistency, is it too thick or not too thick? Enough? Then you see it by yourself if you want it thicker or if you want it more lighter. So let it simmer for a while. Your soup actually is almost finished now. So I'm gonna do now the garniture, the chicken and the ravioli. So the wonton. So you can see it how I do it. All right. Okay. So now I see the consistency of my soup is quite a little bit thick. So I just cooked all my chicken a while ago. I poached them. So I'm gonna use now the excess soup, which when I boiled my chicken legs. Alright. This is all the chicken broth. Alright, you see it's really fine, really white bouillon. Eh? So. See all my chicken there inside, but I suppose this is enough because the rest of the liquid I'm gonna poach my ravioli on it. See also the chicken that I boiled it a while ago, so that's the garniture. Okay, so we're gonna try to mix it once again. So all right, you see now it's quite more liquid between soup and a sauce for your chicken. It's a very light meal in the night. So you can also buy a special bread for this one. But with this one I'm gonna adapt this with a Moroccan bread, which is a special soup that I make for today. I will show you how I'm gonna do it. Well, that's I think it's about it. I'm gonna let it simmer for a while. I think wait for a while and then see what will happen. We'll wait for a while. Nice to have your soup with this kind of bread. It's a Moroccan bread from North Africa, anywhere from Moroccan shop
in Belgium or here in the neighborhood, you can buy them. But this is really for the soup that I made. You know, when you make some halal soup, halal vegetable, but they says, okay, I says that a good product. Because for the moment, it's Corona time, you have to find some product that what you can use in your neighborhood. So you don't have to panic, go to the shop that they're all panicking, but when you see your neighboring shop, they're just chilling, available, and then go and do create something for your own feeling. All right? It's not boiling. I'm gonna put a little bit of parsley on it and a little bit of coriander on it. Wow. But you need more. Okay. Alright, okay, the soup is almost ready. So it's better that I'm gonna use some piping bag to make this wonton, dim sum, whatever you want to call. It's all a fresh product that you made by yourself. You can also make this one. It's like making ravioli. Simple. So if you go to Chinatown or here in my neighborhood, a Thai shop. And this one also the access of my gluten rice. Huh? So I just only I try to grind it. And the chicken must be normally chilled more in the frigo. But I put it just in a piping bag. It's easy. Yeah? Don't overdo it, otherwise you can't press it anymore. So it's important that you use a piping bag for this one. So put it over here, don't overdo it, otherwise you got a problem to press it. Alright, so we just only press it like this. What we're gonna do, we keep this one like this over there for a while. So I'm gonna show you. If you wanna do the petal of your leg, don't do it on this side, at the side, because it's gonna be broken. So do it on this side, so you see nothing can happen if they stay. But if you do it this side, you're gonna have problem. See you see that one? So do it on this side, it's very important. All right detail that you must learn it from the jazz man, listening to jazz, Low Ride by Eric Lou. Wow, what do you need more? I'm enjoying my time. Well, it's Corona time, but because I don't have no time to cook at work to do this kind of message for you guys, but well, I try to, being all my friend in YouTube, and also of course mga kabayan Pilipino, and all my friend all over the world. There are not much, but you know, when you are a Pinoy, you know, we love to cook. Huh? Especially with me, I learned it with my family, Manabat and Fernandez family. They are really what they call in Europe, in Belgium, Bourgogne. You know, they said they're really a food tripper. So you just put some excess of your gluten rice like this. You can do all different. Okay, I'm gonna show you how to do it. So just make so you don't press so much with your piping bag. Do it one time. Huh? So you get fine. So when you poach it or steam it, nothing happened. Let's take this one away. Over here. Alright. Then we use our piping bag. So in a piping bag, you can always control how much do you want to put. It's about, yeah, okay. Maybe you can put it more, but when the smaller, the better. Because you know why? It cooks quicker. I'm gonna show you how to make some all different kind of wonton. All right. Put this piece aside. The most important thing is the piping bag. So what you do, you just take this one over there. Stick it all together, and that side also, like this, so it's just already closed. Don't have contact with the rice noodles. On this side, outside, doesn't matter. So what you're gonna do,
chill for a while, huh? Just leave it like that. Then I'll try it again one more time, so you don't get confused. I'm gonna do it again here, again. You can do also way around, that doesn't matter. Okay? It's only that to make precaution that they don't blow. See again, see? Making sure it's pressed. Let it chill for a while. Turn it again, put your finger over there and over there. Then you have this kind of a sexy raviolis, and then this is another way I want to show you. So this one is different, so you can also do it, just flip it over like this, close it, see, close it like that. So when it's closed, you take a knife or a fork, press it like this. Wow. See, done. So you see, only like this, it's more than enough. So it's just like ravioli, but you know, you have to make sure that's a bit flat. So when it boils, it doesn't blow up. And this one also is also simple. And this is one of my favorite, because you know, as a cook in Europe, you know, we always do it like this. Put it on the other side. It's all about time, you know. If you want to share your time with your family, it's the best thing what you can do. Chill your time in your kitchen at home while it's like Corona time. And then just only try to open it a little bit like this. See? And you can also do it another one. Another one more. And you can just poach them, steam them. Okay, also you can also deep fry them if you like to, it doesn't matter. It's all your own taste. So you have this a sexy one, alright? So you have another one. I'm gonna make one more time. So leave it over here, keep it over there, and make sure that all the rice flour that I did, they had a contact to each other, and then just try to mold them and compress them until that one also make sure that they will go up. Why? It's very important. Otherwise, you're losing the taste of your chicken and everything goes to the bouillon. It doesn't matter. But it's for your security. Take another one. Second time like this is another version. Make sure that it's safe. Alright. Then you have a nice chicken dim sum. So it's well later they're gonna be pop. So I'm gonna show you another one. This is different. So it's all about cooking. This one is different. So what you gotta do? Use the piping bag again. Small one, you turn it like this, you keep on turning, and then what you do, you press on this side, then you have just like candies, you know. You go on this side. Well, everybody do different tricks, you know. When I do this one more, I do a ravioli of a lobster, or I do a ravioli of goose liver. That was all my time in in Glandrop. I'm talking about 20 years ago, 25 years ago, you know, and also in Castel d'Ambrescat, you know, I create all different kind of stuff. So, well, now I just try to revive them, eh? You know, it's on my time. Just like the song says, I don't want to leave you alone by her clue. It's very sentimental, but it meant a lot to me. Alright? Those were my day, my friend. Yes. From motocross to be a special force, now to be a cook. Alright. So you have another candy here. Alright, so you can poach them or you can also deep fry them, but it's up to you. It's all about the meaning of love, how you cook. And it's for me, well, it's a corona time, create something. So now I'm gonna try to finish this one for you. In the meantime, I make my mise en place for my little Nathaniel, all right? Okay. All right, the garniture is ready. So what I'm gonna do now, put all this Moroccan bread on it, put it in the middle. Right. They're all being steamed. Right. All about soup and a different kind of way of cooking. I'm gonna put all this dim sum that I just made a while ago. Put it in the top like this. And you know, it's all chicken sort of ravioli, yeah? Put this wonton. This is a chicken halal. I say, would you like to do something Corona version? All right. The soup, that's the celery soup. I always make this kind of soup. Next time, if you want it again, Nathaniel, I'm gonna always make it like this for you. I know you like a healthy stuff, and it's all soya milk, and there's no dairy on it. And very healthy also. Alright. Okay. About it. Put it over here. I'm gonna put some garniture on it. No. Just put a little bit of parsley. Parsley over there. Also parsley over here. And of course, if you want to have some tomatoes of chili on it, and a little bit of scallion also. All right, because this is a really
home cooking. And of course, when you are at home, don't forget to put some other ways. You can add it yourself. Huh? This is really an old timer sesame oil. It's a Japanese sesame oil. So, all right. So I hope that today the jazz man, during Corona time, I create something halal product for my friend, for my old friend of colleagues from Facebook and also from YouTube. That I hope that this soup that I make for you guys, you enjoy it, because this very healthy during Corona time. Well, when you're at home and it's, when you're free time, try to create this kind of stuff. Well, it's very healthy and you can enjoy this soup to your family. And it was what they call really a freedom chicken. It's a halal product. I love you all a lot. This is Bernie the Jazz Man. Happy cooking. Mabuhay po kayo.